A very pleasant good morning to all my dear friends, students and my dear viewers. Today I am here to present active and passive voice in future tense and models. So today's topic is active and passive voice. When we are talking about future tense, there are only two tenses which can be converted into passive voice, because passive voice is when the work is done. It's never about it's being continued. It's about future. Future mein future perfect tense is okay, but future perfect continuous is again not okay. As you must have noticed that even in present tense and past tense, we are not talking about changing perfect continuous tense into passive voice. That does not happen, right? Let's take the example, affirmative sentence in active voice. You must reveal the facts. You must reveal the facts. Here, for future tense, I am taking must over here. Many of you might say, why is it not will? You will reveal the facts is also equally correct, right? However, here we are taking you must reveal the facts. Passive voice, we have to interchange the two things. You must reveal the facts. You is the subject, the doer. What he is supposed to do, he is supposed to reveal the facts. Facts is the object. So, interchanging the positions, here we have facts must be revealed by you. What do we see? Facts must be revealed by you. In passive voice, we are always talking about V3, third form of verb. Here you have a model along with the first form of verb. In passive voice, must changes to must be, and passive voice, third form of verb, V3. So let's learn the structures. Affirmative voice. Affirmative sentence in active voice. Object comes in the beginning plus model. It could be any. It could be will, shall, should, must, can, could, might, ought to, used to. Any of the models can be used in the same form of format of future indefinite tense. Object plus model. Here we add B to it plus V3. Plus preposition by, plus subject, followed by question mark. So it is, you must reveal the facts. The facts must be revealed by you. Passive voice, negative sentence, we have object plus model, plus not. The facts must not be revealed by you. So, object plus model plus not plus B plus V3 plus by plus subject. That becomes the negative sentence. Facts must not be revealed by you. Interrogative, the third kind of statement. Now, what do? We interchange the position of object and auxiliary or model here in this case. So, we have model in the beginning plus object plus rest of the statement remains the same, B plus V3 plus by plus subject. So we have facts be revealed by you. Then we have negative interrogative. Passive voice, must facts not be revealed by you. So we have model plus object plus not plus B plus V3 plus by plus subject. So let's read the same sentence, you must reveal the facts, into affirmative passive voice. Facts must be revealed by you. In negative, it becomes facts must not be revealed by you. In interrogative, it becomes must facts be revealed by you. Asking a question, must facts be revealed by you? Or in a negative interrogative, must facts not be revealed by you? So here we have future indefinite tense, all the structures, learn them, and you can apply the same format, the same structure to all the models, right? Mind you, all the models, will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might, ought to, used to, need to, dare, with each of them. You can simply use the same. Now we are going to begin with future perfect tense in passive voice. So let's take an example. They will have helped the needy. That's an active voice sentence. If you study that, here is the subject. Will have helped, verb forms, and object needy. Right? So interchanging the position of subject and object, we have the needy will have been helped by them. Passive voice, the needy will have been helped by them. So for future we have will have been, for passive again coming to V3, and here we have passive voice. So let's learn the structures of passive voice in affirmative. It becomes object plus model plus have plus been plus V3 plus preposition by plus subject, ending in a full stop. So we have object plus model, that is the needy, will have been helped by the by them. If we talk about a negative passive voice sentence, changing the same one into negative one, the needy will not have been helped. So we have object plus model plus not plus have plus been plus V3 plus by plus subject. So that becomes a negative one. The needy will not have been helped by them. Talking about interrogative passive voice, we just need to interchange the model and the object or the subject of the sentence, and here we have model plus object plus have been plus V3 plus by plus subject question mark. So what do we have? Will the needy have been helped by them? Right? Will the needy, the model here is will the needy have been helped by them, or maybe would the needy, which sounds more appropriate. Negative interrogative personal passive voice, here it becomes again model plus object plus not have been. Don't get confused, don't even think of using has with will. Will is always followed by have if need be. Plus V3 plus by plus subject. That's a question mark. So, will the needy not have been helped by them? Or maybe would the needy not have been helped by them? So, having a quick revision, future perfect tense, active voice, structure is subject plus V plus object, will plus object. Subject plus VL will have helped, that is V3 plus object PV, that is passive voice, the needy will have been helped by them. And how do we change it? Affirmative structures, object plus model plus have been plus V3 plus by plus subject, right? So reading the same sentence in all these forms, the needy will have been helped by them, the needy will not have been helped by them, will the needy have been helped by them, or will needy not have been helped by them. Take away from today's lessons. Today we learned about future tense, passive voice. So future indefinite tense and future perfect tense are the only two kinds of tenses in future that can be changed into passive voice. First thing, never ever try to change future continuous tense or future perfect continuous tense into passive voice, because they don't change. Second thing, when we are talking about future tense, it is not just future tense, it also includes the modals. The same structures are applied to modals also and future tense also. So whether you have will, would, have, or have, or maybe have to, can, could, may, might, shall, should, ought to, used to, dare, need to, any of them, you have to use the same structures when changing the sentences from active to passive voice.